Wimps is here for interviewing Tim McCarthy, one of the most famous street artists in North of Ireland. Can you tell us about your life?
My artist name is Vers, which is the name I kind of use when I'm doing large pieces of public art. And I run a company called Reincarnation, which brings art projects to communities. It's all about the rebirth of individuals and communities through being involved in the visual arts. As far as my work's concerned, you can find it all over Ireland. I work quite a lot for the Arts Council here, for city councils. Mm-hmm. I do a lot of work for television commercials, books, publications. So some of it's commercial, some of it's private commission, and some of it's public art.
You are working with young people. Can you tell us more about your work with them?
I very often work with young people who are marginalised, who are involved in antisocial behaviour, and very often they come from communities that have maybe been overlooked. With, you know, education or investment in housing, and it's a way of getting young people to actually work together on a project, to work as a team, to design a mural, to problem solve, to look at maybe their area and give something back to their area on a very large scale, something that they and the whole community can be proud of.
Mm-hmm. What do you think about the legal situation of the street art?
Belfast and Northern Ireland in general are really far behind the rest of the world, especially kind of Europe and Brazil and so on. Mm-hmm. Here it's still very much seen as an illegal activity, whereas in some European countries it's embraced as a legitimate form of art.
Is there a connection between murals and street art?
Very much so, yeah. I mean, they're both in the public domain, they're both done on walls, and they're both produced on a large scale for the public to be able to stand in front mm-hmm. of and look at. There is a difference between street art and graffiti. Graffiti uh-huh. is very, it's a selfish act, it's done by the artist. They write their name on the wall, they rarely do anything else, and it's so that they can look at it and go, my name's on a wall, I'm brilliant. Uh-huh. Whereas street art is always produced to create a thing of beauty for the public to look at, mm-hmm. or is to create something humorous that the public can stand and engage with.
What do you think about murals? Are they street art or a part of street art?
I would say they would fall into the street art category, because whoever has painted them is trying to get a message across to mm-hmm. the wider community. And murals are very much part of our recent cultural history. And I think they are a legitimate expression of culture. And street art is just the next little thing along from that, because, you know, that we've got peace now, as it were, and, you know, the political murals aren't that relevant as much as they used to be, so the next kind of thing is getting young people with talent to produce art on walls that's nothing to do with politics.
Mm-hmm. Can this work drop or separate community together?
It can draw communities together, because mm-hmm. in the past with political murals, maybe not everyone in the community supported mm-hmm. the people that wanted those murals on the wall, the paramilitaries or whoever. And now, especially with us working with communities, we get a whole community together. We ask the whole community, from very small children to senior citizens, what they want in their community on walls. So it's kind of, it's art by consensus, you know, it's a very democratic process, whereas some people just don't like murals on walls, regardless of the content, so there can be division in some areas, where especially older people who just don't get it, mm-hmm. think that's a disgrace, that's an eyesore, I don't like that. But most people we work with absolutely love looking at art on walls.
Okay, thank you for the interview.
You're welcome.